Hello dear friends, welcome to Shiksha Mantra, and today in Shiksha Mantra we have a very special discussion, and this discussion is regarding such a confusion that after watching this video completely, I can assure you, you'd never confuse between these two things. So what is this? Let's begin it with a question. Let me show you a question and find out what the subject we are going to discuss today in Shiksha Mantra. Here, I've written two sentences. And the first sentence says, this is the house where I live now. And the second sentence says, this is where I live now. Now my question is very simple. If you find out the subordinate clauses, let me mark it first, where I live now and where I live now. These two are the subordinate clauses. Now could you tell me which clause are they? What clause is the first one and what clause is the second one? Most of the time I have found my students get confused regarding the proper identity of the clause. Why? This is the question. Okay, so let me check it out. What you have found out, write it down, write down the answer in the comment section below, and I'll check how many of you would provide a proper answer. Okay, so let me answer it. What confusion we get here? Actually, here you have two different options. One is the adverb clause and the other is the yes relative clause. But why? Because it speaks of place. This is the house where I live now. So it speaks of place, and you most of the time you have learned that adverb clauses are place. So when it speaks of a place, obviously this is adverb clause. And the second sentence, this is also speaking of place, so this is adverb clause. But there's another confusion here. The house, this is a noun. And where I live now, it's describing the noun. So is this adverb clause or relative clause? So the confusion comes here. Sometimes you get confused what to be the proper answer, whether it would be adverb or it would be relative. Yes, dear friends, and today in this session, we are going to clear that confusion. So once you just observe this video and find out what I'm saying, it's keenly, if you follow the video, there won't be any confusion. It's very simple. That's why we are going to discuss today the subject. Yes, dear friends, this is adverb clause and relative clause, the mystery behind this. So when you want to solve this mystery, you have to find out two different types of adverbs. So first we have to learn about adverbs. Yes, dear friends, there in adverbs we find two terms. One is called the relative adverb and the other is called the conjunctive adverb. Yes, it's relative adverb and conjunctive adverb. Once you get the idea of the relative adverbs and conjunctive adverbs, your confusion would get just word off. Only to learn what the proper clause is used here, you have to gather the concept of relative adverbs and conjunctive adverbs. So let's find out what they are. Relative adverb is such an adverb which relates a subordinate clause with a noun. So how it is, if you follow the first sentence, this is the house where I live now. Here, where I live now, this subordinate clause is actually describing this noun, the house. So the house is described with this subordinate clause. And here we have used where, and this where, this is actually a relative adverb. Why? Because it has an antecedent noun. It's expressing the antecedent noun. So with a relative adverb, we express an antecedent noun and the result is a relative clause. But if you focus on the second sentence, here you don't have any antecedent noun. No antecedent noun is here. So you must remember the term antecedent noun. So there's no antecedent noun, and here antecedent noun is omitted. That's why it is not used to describe some noun. Rather, it's only an information regarding the place. That's why this is called adverbs of place. So where is used to mean a place, and the result is what? The result is adverb clause. Now here this is adverb clause, but it's describing an antecedent noun. So what is this? This is obviously a relative clause. Yes, dear friends, that's the concept. When the relative adverb is used, it's describing a relative clause, and it's describing an antecedent noun, and the result is a relative clause. So this sentence, this is the house where I live now, this is a relative clause, though it's speaking of a place. And in the second sentence, this is where I live now, here the subordinate clause, where I live now, it doesn't have an antecedent noun. That's why this is a conjunctive adverb. It's used as a conjunction only to manage a link between these two clauses, the principal clause and the subordinate clause, and the result is adverb clause. So just remember these two sentences and you are going to find out everything well, because the same word, what is used here as a relative adverb, here it is used as conjunctive adverb. So it doesn't matter what the word is, it doesn't matter what term we are using, but the matter is how it is used. When it's used as a relative adverb, it produces relative clauses. When it is used as conjunctive adverb, it produces adverbial clauses. Now, how to find out whether it's a relative adverb or conjunctive adverb? Here you have to find out the antecedent noun. If there's an antecedent noun and the clause is expressing the antecedent noun, this is relative adverb, and obviously the noun is relative clause. But when there's no antecedent noun, the antecedent noun is omitted, the adverb used here is conjunctive adverb, and the result is adverb clause. So that's how you can find out the mystery of adverb clause and relative clause, where relative adverbs or conjunctive adverbs are used. But before we conclude, we have to discuss relative adverbs in detail, because we have here discussed only where or the adverbs of place, but relative adverbs can suggest not the place only, rather three different things. What are they? The first one, let us discuss it a bit detail so that you'd find it easy whenever you face such a clause. So we are talking of relative adverbs. Relative adverbs can speak of three things. The first one is place. The second one is time. And the third one is reason. So when we find a relative clause, they can be used to mean these three things. And what are they? Let me find out. For place, we use where. For time, we use when. And for reason, we use why. So the same thing may happen for these three things. These three adverbs, the same thing may happen. They are all relative adverbs when used with an antecedent noun. And if there's no antecedent noun, they are conjunctive adverbs and they would produce adverb clauses. So once you remember all these points, the points regarding relative adverbs and conjunctive adverbs, and obviously what would be the indicator, let me tell you something. If I have produced you a cup of liquid, some transparent liquid, now I ask you could you tell me what is this? Is this acidic or this is basic? So what you will do, you will take a litmus paper and dip it into the liquid to find out whether it's acidic or alkaline. So acidic or alkaline, acidity or its alkalinity, how do you find it out? You would find it out by using a litmus paper. So here we have a litmus paper as well to find out the relative adverb and the conjunctive adverb to make a distinction between the relative clauses and the adverb clauses. And what is that litmus? The litmus is what? We have already told you, the litmus is the antecedent noun. If there's an antecedent noun present and the antecedent noun is expressed, this is obviously relative adverb, and the result is relative clause and the same litmus antecedent noun. If omitted and it's not expressed, only the adverb is used, the conjunction is used, WH conjunction, where, when, how, why, whatever it may be. There's no noun. No noun is expressed. Noun is omitted. That means the litmus isn't there. So you'd consider it as adverb clause, because there the adverb is conjunctive adverb. And that's all, dear students. And here I may conclude that the mystery regarding adverb, relative adverb and conjunctive adverb is solved. And the mystery where you get confused whether it's relative clause or adverb clause is finally solved by means of this litmus. So that's from today. We are returning very soon with many such videos. So stay glued to this channel, like Shiksha Mantra, subscribe it with the bell notification. Very soon we are returning with many such very interesting videos. Until then, bye bye, happy learning.